field of art, if you mean that, it's... I don't remember. I was too little to remember when I started. I've been drawing my whole life, and it started from the point zero of me holding crayon, scribbling something. That's newspaper. And, you know, ever since then, it kind of grew to, you know, step by step. It grew to a classroom, it grew to an environment, to art classes, with teachers, and I've been sent to art school just because my parents wanted to get rid of me a little bit. And, so I was in art school back at home in Vilnius. And after I graduated, I went to Art Academy to study graphic arts. I did enjoy it, but it seemed a bit, you know, too conservative. It was a bit of continuation of what I learned at school. So I wanted a different experience. I moved to London. I wanted to, you know, spend time separately from my parents, find new people, see new countries, and get, you know, a little bit different perspective on art education as well. So, you know, the time in London was very important for me. In terms of what I did after college, it's been all a matter of, you know, trying not to give it up. I try to, you know, absorb my environment, where I go, people I talk, things I see, the books I read, films I watch, everything. It's, you know, every single bit, I think, you know, stays inside my mind, whatever consciously or not is, you know, it influences our perception of, you know, of world, our perception of environment. And as an artist, I think, you know, it's everything comes out as my artwork, because, you know, what comes into me comes out. So I can't point out one single thing. It's, you know, it's just the whole bunch of, you know, experiences which creates something which I'm able to express. I don't know, it's never a single point. It's never a single thing which, you know, makes it happen. It's always a combination of time, situation, the environment, the possibilities you can do, and some, you know, inspiration coming from within you. So it's hard to tell. It's, of course, real life, I don't know. I've never been considering myself as a photographer. I've always been doing photography ever since, you know, perhaps 10 years ago. Just, you know, on a regular basis, snapping then. And there would be sometimes a photograph which I really enjoy, which I really think, you know, has a lot to say and can express a lot what I think about, you know, about where I am. And sometimes, you know, I would have that photograph in my mind for the rest of 5 years in the future without really knowing what it's gonna be, what it is for. It's not a piece of photography, I'm not a gallery photographer, I'm not, you know, press photographer, it's not gonna get published. I do publish sometimes my photographs as a journalist, but it's not really a function of, you know, seeking in my photographs. And then at some point, you walk down the street and you see a place or you see a location, it can be anything, and you think, this is it, this is what, you know, that was what it's been waiting for. And I think the important thing is just finding that right combination about something. I don't think art is something about a single point to express. It's not, you know, shouting a slogan, advertisement, this, it says, you know, this is it, right? Advertisement can be actually, you know, can be creative. Design can be creative, but it stands for a single point. It stands for aesthetics, it stands for a problem, it stands for idea. It can be, you know, political slogan, then it's a single point of view and a single inspiration. And it's artwork, it's a multiple experience. There is no such a thing. No such a thing as the best thing being an artist. In my experience, the fact that I don't have to wake up every day at 8 o'clock in the morning is good enough for me. In artwork or in general, in my art practice, I think it's my art practice. It's the painting itself. Then you get really into it when you... Being a full-time artist doesn't mean you're producing art full-time. Being a hobby artist might mean you produce more artwork than being a full-time artist. But, you know, it's a lot of time consumed by organizing it, making it happen, logistics, materials, exposure, management. It's you know, it's a lot of tasks you have to deal with, and of course the actual art, you know, the actual painting process is the most enjoyable for me. From my point of view, I know it's silly to say, but I think art has no function in this world. It's something which just doesn't have a task. It does not tend to complete anything. It doesn't save life. It doesn't sell products. It doesn't teach you anything in a literal way. It's so, thinking that way, there is no reason to do art whatsoever. And the main qualities of an artist is, I think, is understanding that and still doing it and believing in it. It's believing that it serves something higher than, you know, physical experience can actually, you know, value. It's something what is an idea which might not necessarily have to turn into into physical profit as such, into something educational or into something financially material. And it's so, being an artist is something which is understanding this and still going for it and still doing it. There's thousands of reasons not to do it, but and I think every single person in the world can do it. It's just about the people who make decisions not to. Probably continuing the same idea, there's a lot of reasons not to do it, and kind of people tend to find to wait for reasons to, you know. I see a lot of creative people trying to sitting there waiting for something to be able to do it. There's if you want to do something and you don't know where to start, it's start where you are, use what you have and do what you can. That's all I can say.